Pirates at work on the west side tonight, haven't stolen treasure, rather an FM radio frequency. And what they're playing is music with enough foul language to get residents calling the feds. Local 12's Anjanette Levy is in West Price Hill tonight. She's got their concerns, Anjanette.
Well, Brad, that low band FM station was playing earlier tonight, or earlier this afternoon, rather. But tonight, it's not playing much of anything except static. People over here just happened to stumble upon this station, and we can tell you what they're hearing is not music to their ears.
My mother's always stressing I ain't living right, but I ain't going out without a fight.
Mind Playing Tricks on Me. It's one of the Geto Boys' biggest hits. Drive along Glenway Avenue, and you'll hear them unedited on 87.9 FM.
That was going down like them, I didn't get...
Pete Whitty says someone hijacked the frequency a couple of months ago, and it's playing rap music on radios in Westwood, West Price Hill, and North Fairmount. It's filled with words you can't say on the radio or TV.
It's very challenging as a parent to listen to this channel and then think that my kids, on a whim or by being influenced by friends, could tune this in.
And you're listening to WMKV 89.3 FM.
No one knows who's hijacked the frequency, but Dave Schramm of WMKV FM says it's not difficult to do.
Not many people realize you can go on the internet and literally buy an exciter and an antenna and the cabling to go with it. You do not need an FCC license to do this.
But Schramm says it's a very bad idea. The FCC takes pirate radio seriously, and the signal could interfere with licensed radio stations.
If it ends up being one of the larger radio groups in town that you end up stepping on with your frequency, you're going to find out they're not going to be very happy with you.
I'm staring at the woman on the corner.
Local hip-hop artist Ilyas Nasheed says the Geto Boys are an important part of rap music history, but he thinks what's going on 87.9 is pretty odd.
I don't see the motivation for it. Because, like, when I used to hear about pirate radio, it would be somebody playing music that wasn't very popular in the mainstream, or they would be doing something that was very politically motivated.
The Geto Boys actually play Cincinnati this weekend. By then, Pete Whitty hopes whomever is playing their music will be off the air.
We need the FCC to address this, and I'm kind of curious to know how they will do this.
And again, Pete Whitty said it's not the genre, it's not the rap music that bothers him, it's simply the vulgar language. I contacted the FCC for a comment. The agency declined. Reporting live from West Hill, Anjanette Levy, Local 12 News. Brad?
Anjanette, thank you. Dave Schramm says that the FCC will typically give a pirate radio operator a warning to stop hijacking the signal, but if the use continues, the person can get up to a $10,000 fine.